Mr. Naval from Exchange for Media, co-founder. Please let me have a huge round of applause for Mr. Naval Ahuja for the welcome address.
Good morning. Thank you for being here. This is the first day of the NEONS conference. Actually, we've been doing it for a few years, but it's been more a half-day affair. The NEONS Outdoor Advertising Awards has been around for now 7 years. So I'm glad to see a lot of you from the industry who have joined here. Thank you also for our well-wishers, supporters, Aresh Nayak, Rachna, for having come all the way from Mumbai to be part of this conference. I see other friends here, Pawan from Amul, who's flown down, Sai is here, the Lakshya team is here. So glad you're all here to support this initiative. Outdoor industry is obviously in for better days. The elections are around the corner. I'm told by some friends that a lot of outdoor spending is about to start. So I see a lot of cheerful names and the people in the room today. Hopefully that spending momentum will continue this year. We annually do this pitch medicine advertising report, which projected better spends this year. Last year, the outdoor industry grew by, I think, around 8.5%. This year, the expected spend growth is 11%. That's a decent jump, but, given that elections are there and then post that, there's World Cup and then obviously the festive season momentum, hopefully outdoor industry should grow more than 11%. There is also a lot of push towards, making measurement available, making transparency better. So I think the outdoor industry has come a long, long way from where it used to be 20 years back. In terms of evolution on transparency, in terms of measurement, in terms of utilization of digital. So what we have done today is we put together an agenda which kind of involves conversations from both sides of the fence, which is the advertisers, the agencies who are spending money, and the outdoor owners who are the asset owners. So if you see the agenda, there are lots of large brands represented here from Airtel, ITC, Amul, Mahindra, Z, Ola, Panasonic, and so on. And then we also have some of the outdoor owners represented. In the evening, we also have Deputy Commissioner of the South Delhi Municipal Corporation making a special address. Delhi Municipal Corporation is, of course, one of the largest outdoor owners in this city, and they do set the agenda on what's happening in the outdoor business in Delhi. So with that, thank you all of you for being here again, and happy Women's Day to all of our women colleagues for spending the day with us. I do hope we have a fruitful day and go back with a lot of learning. My congratulations also to all the award winners in the night, and we look forward to celebrating all together. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. And now moving on, we will start with our first panel discussion, ladies and gentlemen. That is, why brand custodians turn towards OOH in the era of internet? For brand custodians, traditionally platform, it is a platform, traditional platform like television, and OOH continue to stay relevant given the sheer power of their visual impact, while digital might be relevant and gaining currency by the decreasing attention span of its users does not make it a platform for creating big impact. This panel will explore the nuances of the digital versus OOH narrative. I now invite our session chair, Mr. Jayesh Yagnik, COO, Moms Outdoor Advertising. Jayesh, with over 18 years of domain experience, started his career with Moms and eventually grew into the role of heading the organization nationally, and has worked with clients across categories including Asian Paints, Raymond's, Oppo, Kotak Bank, India Bulls, Bandhan Bank, Godrej, Marico, Pidilite, Toyota, and many, many, many others. So ladies and gentlemen, please put your hand together for Mr. Jayesh. We have another panelist here. She is our wonderful and dynamic personality. Let me call upon Ms. Archana Agarwal, VP Media Airtel. Can I have a round of applause for the dynamic lady here? Next, we have Jay Kishan Chapro from Media Head, ITC Limited. Ladies and gentlemen, can I have Mr. Loud round of applause for Mr. Jay Kishan. Next, we have Mr. Pawan Singh. He's the National Head Marketing from Amul. Pramod Patil, Associate VP Media, Kotak Mahindra Bank. Please put your hands together for all our panelists. We have Pramod Patil also joining us on the dais, Associate VP, Kotak Mahindra Bank, and Sujit Mishra, VP and Head Marketing, Z Media. Please put your hands together for Mr. Sujit Mishra. And finally, we have Sai Nagesh, the Chief Strategy Officer from Lakshya Media Group. So now I would like to request Mr. Jayesh Yagnik to kindly take over the session. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Well, good morning, everyone, and what a beautiful day. It's such an beautiful event for International Women's Day when we are starting this. So one more time, can we have a loud round of applause for all the women in the house, please? And well, now moving on from a beautiful day to the beautiful topic what has been given. It's like, why brand custodian turned towards OOH in the era of internet? And for a person like me who has always been breathing OOH throughout his career, it cannot get better than this when I have so many brand custodians sitting here and where I have to ask and hear so many good things which I'm sure going to come from this. Let me start. I mean, let's begin with you, Archana. I'll just start with this question, saying long-held view is out of home is one particular media which is unmissable when it is in the line of the sight of consumers. Besides the dominating present it creates, which is unmatched for the brand, would you agree that OOH is here to stay regardless of the invention of the internet in our life?
Good morning to everybody. 10, 12 years ago, with the advent of digital, I used to hear in every conference that I used to go to that now TV is dead. And now we are talking about, OOH being dead, or is it going to survive? I think that every medium has a role to play in an advertiser's world. And I don't see OOH dying. I just think that OOH needs to keep evolving itself with the trying to meet the new needs of the millennials. Because today, I think the biggest challenge that OOH faces is that while there is this impact and these large scale holdings which are available everywhere and a lot more new opportunities which are there, but today if you look around, in the metros, in the buses, even in cars, people are busy on their phones. So they're always looking down. How do you get those consumers to start looking up into the outside and seeing the holdings? I think that's a challenge today. I don't see that, there will be a role always for the OOH medium to play in every brand and advertiser's media plans. But how important it is going to continue to be, I think that's where the industry has to come and evolve and continuously evolve to make it, to keep it relevant for an advertiser.
Sure. Let's see this from Sai's point of view. Sai, what do you think? I mean, we have heard from the brand point of view and advertiser point of view. You, throughout your career, being multiple side and now with the agency side, what do you think? And would you agree OOH is here to stay?
Okay. Morning, everybody, and thanks, Jayesh, for this. Okay, let's just get back to where are we as a country, okay? We are a millennial-dominated country. 65% of our population below 35 years of age, 18 to 35. What do they do? Spend time outside home. Most, 70% of the waking hours are outside home. And when they're outside home, they're consuming whatever is outside, right? In-home consumption amongst them has completely declined, and it's being in another form. So OTT has taken over television. your digital, your news websites have taken over the newspapers in that other form, right? And 3 hours, 56 minutes is the average time spent on a daily basis on multiple screens by the millennial generation. But if you look at the average time spent per view, it's never more than 2.5 minutes. So what does the guy or the girl do after staring at the screen for 2.5 minutes? Something, somewhere, some engagement, somewhere something is capturing the attention, right? And that's why I believe OH plays a very important role. And I've seen it because this is the first time I'm working with the OH industry since I joined Laksh. But the possibilities are enormous. It's all about placement, context. And as Archana so rightly mentioned, you know, when internet started, people said TV is dead, right? When digital started, people said everything else is dead. Nothing has happened in any part of the world. It's just changed formats. So I think it's time for OH also in this country to change in terms of how it looks and feels. Maybe digital OH is now long overdue, yeah? But it will continue to play a role purely because millennials are outside home. And that's my submission. Thank you.
Sure. Thanks, Zai. Well, I move on to Jayesh now. Jayesh, Indian small towns, we know that in rural and all, penetration of internet is, growing day in day. And in other end, OH, with OH also, we can reach to the lowest pop strata of the country. So how would you look at both the mediums in terms of the reach, what they provide?
See, broadly, if you look at it, each medium has a significant role to play in its own manner. So for example, if I have to reach out to masses, I would technically go on to television or something. When you
okay, is it audible now?
Yeah, okay. So as I was saying that, each medium has its own role to play. If I have to kind of reach out to the masses, I would go on the television route. Okay. However, when you're talking about the rural audiences and the fact that mobile has penetrated deeply and Jio is kind of providing the access for internet to these people, the amount of consumption of linear TV that is happening on Jio is unbelievable. So in fact, some time back, we were doing some market visits in rural Bihar. And trust me when I tell you this, the average time spent on content was on Zee Studio, and the show they were watching was America's Next Top Model. And this was a time when Big Boss was also active. So about 30 minutes was being consumed on watching America's Top Model. And Big Boss had an average viewership of 26 minutes. The closest was one of the Bhojpuri content, which was about 32 minutes. So, if I have to kind of put these stats up, you know that internet is kind of gunning in. But again, this is also a market which probably has low literacy rates and other things. And what they understand is faces, colors, numbers. And therefore, if you look at the way outdoor pans out and the kind of brands that pan out in this market are identified either by colors or the animals or the numbers that you kind of put up there. So, Patswik, Bataka Biri, Bandar, Chhab, Lal, Dand, Banjan, and stuff like that.
True. So great. Pawan, what is your point? I mean, for you also, brand Amul, the mass reach is one of the core factor I'm sure you would be looking at, and the kind of reach what OH which provides, down the pop strata towns and all, with sheer reach what it gives. How would you look at this particular thing versus digital?
Well, the way I look at it is, whether it's big cities or small towns, okay, whether it's the affluent class or the lowest economic strata, both digital and OH will continue to make sense, and therefore they will be relevant. Now look at the reality of India today. Digital is the next big wave, everyone agrees, I'm sure, because today 4G smartphones are available at what, 4,000 to 7,000 rupees, and a 4G, good 4G data plan at what, 100 rupees a month, correct? So now, even in the lowest pop strata, even in semi-rural, semi-urban areas, digital marketing has become a reality. But then, see another angle of it. Outside bigger cities, network issues are there. They impact data speeds. So today in a small town, you put a good strategically located billboard, and that delivers far better results than digital marketing does today.
Great. Good right. To hear that.
So, I mean, all of them are here to stay. See, one thing I agree with both Archana and Sai, of course, that in today's modern lifestyle, and I am a marketing professional, a brand custodian, I have never believed that the game of brand building can ever be media specific. Okay? It's always brand building is about how we work on our human relationships. But then to get any relationship going in the first place, you need opportunities to meet, to connect, engage, and to attract, right? And there, out-of-home media scores the best. It gives us maximum touch points to connect to, and the most technologically innovative ways to engage and attract a target audience. And that's the way I look at it.
Oh, great. Good to hear that. Well, from the mass reach, I'll move on to niche reach. And, you know, we have Pramod here from Kotak, you know, where they will be looking at more of a niche reach as compared to mass. Pramod, let me ask you something like a Nielsen study which was conducted in 2017 that established that OOH is the most effective offline medium in driving online connectivity. Now, you know, quite a few campaigns we see that, you know, you guys have done like 811 and all those kind of a thing where you would want more of a online interactivity through offline media. The study revealed that the medium delivers 4 times more online activity per ad dollar spent than TV, radio, and print. So what's your thought on having OOH in your plans, considering all this, that it's more relevant in driving offline to online ratio?
So first of all, because those studies are conducted in other markets, frankly, right now what we are looking for is, can we do those kind of studies in India? Okay. But to go back to your question, yes, when we use outdoor, we look at outdoor from both point of view. One is reach, definitely. Second is impact, and that impact should drive some amount of leads, conversion, and all. But that's not the metric we look for. In one way, I would admit that we look outdoor as last broadcast medium, announcement medium, reach medium, impact medium. But should we look outdoor as a conversion medium too? That as at a BFI industry level, we haven't done so far. But it's the time to evaluate and see if we can do that. Like the analysis what you mentioned, we at our end also tried to do some kind of analytics and strangely didn't throw that kind of numbers. But at the same time, it recommended us that, you know, outdoor would be used for lowest reach conversions and all. So yes, we are looking forward for such kind of analysis.
And purely from the talkability and the engagement point of view, I mean, we all know Amul and how topical Amul ads are and all that. The one of the most topical thing what you guys have used of recently with Ranveer Singh, how does that overall thing, you know, impacted or created a result for the brand with card mila kya campaign, what you have done it?
That's a good joke we played, and thankfully Ranveer agreed for it. It says, I'm not sure whether Delhi market is aware about that campaign because we did in limited markets. So what we did exactly at the, when his wedding was talked about and all that, we realized, and we were about to launch a new debit card, which has Ranveer on its, Ranveer's face was on the card. So we realized there is an opportunity, and a folded hand Ranveer asking on huge outdoors that card mila kya. While people were assuming that he is talking about his marriage, actually that was a teaser campaign which was talking about our debit card. And the campaign was well appreciated, people noted it, and that's the beauty of outdoor. So as soon as we launched it, in next 1 hour, I mean, in the morning we started getting calls from journalists, everyone and all that, and the campaign was noticed. And that is the engagement I'm talking about, which outdoor offers, which no other media offers. Every time when we put up outdoor hoarding, we realize, we get to know that Kotak campaign is on. In fact, let me put it this way. Kotak campaign is launched, people notice only when there's outdoor campaign. Okay. When it's a TV campaign, it takes time. In fact, there are a lot of studies which talk about outdoor campaign builds visibility faster, like 80% of visibility they build in 1 week, which is faster than TV actually. TV takes time, but it gives you a higher reach, but outdoor builds reach faster. So from that point of view, it created that curiosity, it created that moment for us. And like you said, you know, the campaign was noticed. And that was the part we were looking at. Yeah.
Great. Thank you. Let me move to Sujit now. Sujit, global markets where interactivity with the OOH is one of the, you know, very growing phenomena, where you have a lot of touchscreen places, QR code scanning, you can do a lot of interactive thing through outdoors and all. In India, the efforts are being made and few people have been successful and started this thing. What is your point of view on such interactivity on OOH? That where will it lead to, and will it help OOH as a medium to increase its share of pie in the overall advertising thing?
Well, I'll just take a step back to explain the thought. I'm saying that, you know, while Jayesh and the rest of the panelists have mentioned about it, that all these mediums are, you know, they have their relevant roles to play. And how it is really important for all these mediums to leverage their strength is something which I call as the creative has to decide that which medium the justice will be done. So, you know, broadly I put creatives into two different buckets, and I say that, you know, there is a set of creative which you call as lean-in creative, which is more of an informative creative, like mostly banking and insurance. You will find a lot of information in the creative itself, which I call as lean-in. You have to really read to make a decision whether you want to purchase or not. There are second set of creative which I call as lean back, where, you know, you don't really need to get into the details of it, but sometimes even headline does the job. Okay, so those are the creatives which are very, very clear, and, you know, you don't need to get into really to get the message to brand. Now, putting these two buckets separately, you know, there has to be a right medium selected for these creatives to do justice. Okay. Coming on to the media side, what I would say, you know, I classify media into three broad buckets again here, and for simplicity I refer it as PFI medium, and it's not popular front of India, by the way. So P stands for public, F stands for family, and I stands for individual. Now, you see, what are the public mediums? You know, in my view, outdoor falls into a public medium. Right. When it comes to F, which is family, you know, you have television to some extent, you have print, which falls into that category. And, you know, internet is really I, the individual. You consume yourself. The two sides, the creative and the media side, has to coexist. And imagine a very, very informative ad of an insurance being put up on outdoor screen becomes so difficult for somebody to read. Yeah, but when it goes on internet, yeah, it does the job. Okay, whereas a TV advertising, which broadly becomes a very clean and, you know, headline does the job, for us outdoor works fantastic. You know, for cleaner advertising, internet also works, and that's the advantage of internet. You know, for those ads, you know, which are very, very clear in its messaging, works both ways. So the creative has to really decide which media it is going to be, you know, used on and do the job. Okay. Now, as far as the second part of the question, which you're talking about, the innovation in digital space and, you know, innovation in outdoor, what marketers are looking nowadays is more of an integrated media solutions. So, you know, sometimes, you know, you would want the leads to come through outdoor and really get into internet for more information. So suppose as a television brand, if I'm launching a contest, you know, for me, what works is both outdoor and internet. I would like people to know what is the broader benefit that they're getting through this contest, but the information will be there on the internet. So those kind of integrations are required. And in that format, the innovation in outdoor, which has been a global practice now, which started coming into India, works beautifully for us. So that's how we look at, you know, media planning from as far as television is concerned.
Great, Sujit. Thank you. Archana, from a marketer point of view, would you like to add on this? Because we have lot many media concessioners here. So as a marketer, what kind of interactivity would you like to see in terms of OOH space? Something which you have done or something which you would like to do, which if you can share with everyone.
Okay, so, you know, I remember a few years ago, I was on the jury for one of the OOH awards, and I'd seen this mother dairy creative, and it was one of the first few which I remember, and it's still right in my mind, about the interactivity which was done, which was as consumers passed the hoarding, there was a, you know, good morning or some message which was given on the mobile phone. Now, obviously, that was, I think, one of the first few interactive, you know, OH that was done. I think my biggest challenge, so obviously, there is a huge amount of interactivity that can be built into the campaigns, into OH. I think the biggest challenge as an advertiser I face is how do you ensure there's scale in this whole piece? So how do you bring scale and it being at a cost-effective, in a cost-effective manner? I think most of the interactive OH which gets done that I have seen in the past, we haven't frankly done anything as of now, is and largely because sometimes the costs become quite prohibitive. How do you bring this, you know, most of the people I've seen is doing it in one or two locations and, you know, and it becomes an innovation. But I think it needs to now move out from that innovation space and become more part of the regular plans. How do you make this as part of the basic plan like we would do on a regular outdoor campaign versus it being this one-off innovation that I'm doing? And how do you ensure, how do you help bring down these, drive down these costs, and that's only when it'll move out from being an innovation to a much more scalable, you know, become much more scalable.
So mass reach is what you're talking about through OOH and not driving it through, yes, digitally after doing one of the thing and all.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So yeah, it's something which can give us a better CPT or...
Yeah, because that will allow, you know, measurability in terms of what is this giving. I think one of the biggest problems is measurability in this medium. Most other mediums have some level of measurability, yes, which this doesn't. In fact, you know, in Airtel, what we do is when we do, you know, media analytics. So we do yearly media analytics to understand how, what is the role of each medium. And outdoor also goes into this analytics. And which is why, if you've seen, we've been advertising continuously on outdoor for some of our campaigns. It may not be for all because we look at the relevance of the campaign and if there's newness of the messages we want to drive or we want to just continue driving a particular message. And that's how we measure because we look at the measurability more not from a, you know, is it going to drive business, but more from a brand perspective. Is it driving top of mind for me? Is it driving consideration and stuff like that? So that's what we look at it from, that's what we look from an analytics standpoint because that helps me arrive at what's the role that each medium plays in my media mix.
Great. Talking about the measurability and analytics, I'm moving on to the next thing, which is talking about that. So let me move to Jayesh, you now. You know, you guys are one of the leading FMCG brand of the company. But as compared to the other FMCG companies which are there in terms of the OOH share, the kind of spend, what they do in this particular media, your OOH share, your company's OOH share in this overall thing, is not comparable as far as over other competition is concerned. Is this mainly to do with the kind of measurement? Now that OOH planning is also done with the use of, you know, quite a few sophisticated tools which has been developed by individual media specialists and agencies, the audience measurement metrics and monitoring system also being developed across agencies like app monitoring, etc. Also, Outdoor Association, IOWH, has initiated a step towards creating an OOH currency. So, you know, it's getting momentum and to ensure the measurability in OOH space. Would you agree that importance of OOH will only grow more so with so many innovative OOH formats taking place?
Okay, so I'll answer it in the reverse order. One is, yes, the importance definitely is going to grow. For a variety of reasons, and I'll kind of touch upon it when I'm kind of responding it to the first part of the question with regards to the share of spend that probably ITC is doing currently versus the other FMCG players. See, also it depends on the categories that we are operating and the markets we are operating in. At least for the businesses that I handle, we have in the recent one, we have a significant amount of outdoor, whether it is for the personal care business or whether it was for our apparel brands. And so it's a sizable number. See, as I said, the requirement of a medium gets defined by the creative. Sujit also kind of mentioned and touched upon it, talking about the PFI model and other things. So when you talk about measurability, it's still kind of at a very nascent level, if I would put it. Okay, is there a equivalent of a Bach that we have today, which can technically pinpoint and say, okay, if I have run a campaign of, let's say, in 40 markets, average of 40 sites in each market, what kind of reach or frequency do I get? Or versus a digital, you know, in terms of what kind of impressions I'm getting. I don't get that kind of data right now. And, you know, the interesting thing is, if you look at placing ads on digital as well as on outdoor, that initial time span is absolutely similar. You know that technically if you don't get the message in the first 5 seconds on the outdoor piece, you kind of move on, and that likewise you have a skip option on ad that's kind of being played out there. Unless you're kind of on a non-skippable format, and there's a traffic jam equivalent on for the outdoor business. So, you know, those kind of things exist, but measurement doesn't, okay? Second thing is, no two plans are alike. So for example, if I have two different campaigns coming up on outdoor, it's not necessary that the objective of both the campaigns is going to be similar. Right. Is there a model that exists with the OH agencies or even the site owners today, which gives me a, let's say for example, if I want a 600 GRP plan on TV, I broadly know what kind of mix I would go with. Something like that doesn't exist, okay? It doesn't exist probably because of the way the industry is structured today. It's multi-layered. You have a site owner, probably a leasee, you have an agency, and then you have the undercutting that happens. So for example, if a plan is being sought from three different agencies, today the entire game is in terms of trying to see who's giving me the best cost. Is the industry ready to kind of come and say, ki, boss, okay, here is a rate card, irrespective of whatever agency you're going to go with, this is the plan cost, and then the business is completely kind of basis of servicing that happens or the kind of after sales, if I would put it, that happens with the outdoor business totally.
Right. So will it, the measurability and when Bach kind of an equivalent which comes, which can give you a GRP thing, which IOEE is working on that, will this kind of a study will help brand like yours to increase the overall outdoor spend?
See, because what happens is, today, thanks to the e-com sales and other things, you can technically get geolocations in terms of where the sales spikes are happening. Okay, to a pin code level, I know where my product is having a certain amount of offtake. I know there are certain geographies within a city which are currently not consuming my set of products in the same quantum as probably the adjacent pin codes. If I have to reach out to that local level, the best option that I have is outdoor at that point of time.
So that phenomenal hyper-local connection which outdoor can provide, unless you give the study for that and brands are ready to spend on that.
When I'm saying outdoor, I'm not restricting it to billboards. I'm saying it's entire OH, the street furniture and the entire paraphernalia which kind of comes in the ambit of OH.
Right. Sure, thanks. Taking Sai's point of view on this, Sai from a strategy point of view in outdoors, what do you think about this measurability and, ratings on out of home and all, which will be more from a syndicated point of view kind of a study, and rather than an individual, which all the agencies have today, their individual study, which creates doubt in marketeers' mind that, you know, my study is better than that or not, you know, it's everyone having their own story. What is your point of view when the syndicated study coming up, how the brands would react to that?
Look, in the time that I've been here and interacting with clients, and one thing has been is very, very clear. What Jay Kishan said is so true. You know, outdoor is a commodity, right? So irrespective of what skills, what expertise, what brand knowledge you may have, and what precision targeting you may do, ultimately it comes down to cost, unfortunately, right? And that's where I guess this desperate need for measurability and accountability and, of course, transparency. So a lot of agencies have done it. We also just developed a software called Sharp, which is kind of, we've taken the 2011 census and layered it with multiple levels of databases, including a lot of API integrations, and we hope it's going to give some real sharp answers. It's just been developed. We just launched it in the marketplace. This got developed because of the need for reach OTS for a plan, just as you were saying about, you know, GRPs and reach OTS. Is there a need for an industry currency? I'm sure every client sitting here would definitely agree, because then it kind of gives a level playing field, no, in terms of expertise and offering solutions. And I think we need to move fast, because globally, if you see, you know, there are only two media which are growing in every part of the world, whether it's Western world or the US markets or whatever, even African. It's just outdoor and digital. Every other medium is either stagnant or it's just been, you know, where whatever. So if rest of the world is telling us a story and the picture is very apparent, and India has never been very far behind, right, in all these developments that are happening today, I think it's time we get ready for it. And if individual agencies have developed their own skill set, somewhere one has to, I think, come together and say, okay, this is what I have, this is what you have, and, you know, what do we kind of take the best practices and get a couple of, you know, big clients on board, take their point of view and kind of make the move forward.
Sure. Okay. So, you know, before starting this, as Naval said at that time that after, you know, from past 3 years, the growth of OOH as a medium was in single digit, and now after 3 years, we're going to have a growth in double digit, which has been predicted at 11% this year, and because of a lot of reason like elections, IPL, World Cup and all that, which is going to happen in a festive which will follow that. But in the same Pitch Madison report, if you see the overall pie of OOH in this year, it's going to go to 5% from 6%. So overall, as an OOH, as an entire advertisement spends, you know, from past 4 years, it's consistent at about 6%. This year, it's alarming at 5%. So where we are talking about the growth in double digit, but the way, at the rate which other medias, especially digital, is growing, the overall pie of advertising is reducing. So with this kind of a study and this kind of a thing, what is the kind of impact do you think it will create? Will it help in increasing the overall advertising pie to, you know, certain percentage?
Yeah, I think the client sitting here will agree with me. One of the most glaring weaknesses of this medium is there is no custodian for this medium. Look at digital, how it's being evangelized. Every day there's an article on something or other, how the nanoseconds of decisions are being influenced by digital media, etc., etc. Kindly tell me, gentlemen, lady, and everybody sitting here, when was the last time you saw a series of articles on how OOH was a vector, right? From a very, bird's eye point of view, or case studies, or there's nobody who's taking ownership. There's no custody. There's no owner of this medium, right? Whether it's the association, I'm sorry to say, or whoever has needs to, and digital is the best example. Believe you me, you start doing that, add to that your measurability that a lot of agencies are talking about, put a common currency in place, there's no reason why we shouldn't grow, number one. Number two, in an industry growing at 16%, if we're still retaining 5 to 6%, we're also growing at 16%. So it's not bad. The point is that good enough? I don't think so. The potential is very large. I mean, look at case studies abroad. They've done magic with OOH, because that's what gives you size, that's what gives you location, targeting, you know, a whole lot of stuff that's there. So, yes. A lot of stuff can be done, and I think potential is huge.
Yes, please.
Can I just add, taking forward from Sai's point, he's right, there's so much, I mean, most advertisers didn't know anything about digital when it started, okay, but we've learned, because there was people who were willing to come and give classes, master classes after master class. The Googles, the Facebooks of the world were ready there trying to, educate people, and they continue to do so. And Sai's right, there's nothing happening in the OOH world, and what we know about OOH is, okay, it's a mass medium, you can drive impact, you can maybe, it's out of home, so just ensure that all the roads, the main highways and stuff like that are, you have your outer, it's a gut feel. Is there, how do you ensure that there is education as to what's the right thing to do, right? So how do you, I think it's important to keep educating marketers constantly, not only through case studies, because that's the next level. Their case studies are equally important, but how do you educate them? What's the right way to plan? What's sufficient, right? Because that's when marketers will see the value of this medium and try to advertise much more when they see the need.
Sure. Thanks. Moving on to Pawan, let me ask you. These days, the OOH landscape is changing drastically. It's getting decluttered and increasingly blending into, a lot of city landscapes and all. Iconic OOH medias are coming up at the many places, like in and around airports, metro station. You have this new thing, metro station naming rights and large railway station, digital screens inside stations and all that. We saw a few videos there before we started. So digital screens inside airport and stations, etc., those promise a complete different brand experience, to say. Will this, according to you, will help brand say like yours, to have a positioning on such a grand scale?
Well, of course, yes. The decluttering, the integration of OOH touch points into the cityscape, that was always on the cards, right? Because as the aesthetic sense, the local civic sense, started gaining primacy, there would be a momentum, a call for decluttering. Now, from the brand point of view, from a marketeer's point of view, is always a welcome step because it makes our brand presence and visibility on out-of-home media look less intrusive, mm-hmm. right? It looks less force-fed. And then, of course, it gives us that opportunity of creating visibility on a grand scale. So I completely agree with you. One more thing, from just taking over from what Arshana said, there is, from I'm addressing a lot of people who belong to the out-of-home media industry here, I believe there's a greater need for you to engage and reach out to the brands. Because brands would be more willing to experiment with possibilities provided they're aware what the possibilities are in the first place. Okay, so there has to be a greater effort to engage with the marketeers and just educate them as to what can be done. There's so much of innovation that's available. Come on, we've been talking about the digital versus out of home, and which, why is digital growing at such a rapid rate and why our share is from 6% to 5%. Well, in my opinion, both these media have a good future. They have a bright future for the simple reason that they will continue to remain relevant. They continue to make sense. I cannot give the same assurance for either television. I think they will definitely in future slip behind the conventional giants today. But digital and out of home will continue to make sense. Why? Modern lifestyles, we spend 13 hours at home, out of home, right?
Yeah.
Right. For work, for shopping, for work, anything.
True.
And out of 11 hours we spend at home, I guess 6 to 7 hours of sleep we get every day, every night. So where's the time to read newspapers? Where's the time to watch television, right? And then, when we are out, on the move, and we want to engage with our target on the move, they can do only two things. They can either look up and around, or they can look down on the screens. All right? And if we as a brand get the chance to engage with our target audience in both the ways, when they are doing the screen time, or when they're looking up and around, say they're walking or driving or self-navigating, then why not? So I think both of them can connect with each other. Interactivity is a point that you touched upon, and you spoke about it quite a lot. I think interactivity can very easily be achieved by simple, clever, intelligent integration of even static OOH with digital. And both of them can combine and amplify each other's impact.
Yeah, just, sorry.
See, if you look at it, I was just kind of thinking, OOH is the only medium wherein the audience has zero investment. Okay, for example, if he wants to watch TV, he has to invest in a TV set, into a net connection and stuff. If you have to read a newspaper, to buy a newspaper, he has to be literate. Likewise, for radio set or digital consumption, OOH, he just needs to step out of the house. Okay, one. Second is, if you look at the kind of innovations and technology adoption that OOH has done, is unbelievable. So the kind of on television, the kind of innovations you will see, something to do with content, something to do with ad space and stuff. Likewise, the newspaper will just use the medium. OOH has actually evolved over a period of time. The building wraps, or even that British Airways holding using technology, RFID, the kind of stuff that Carlsberg has done with that Google Cardboard and all. The kind of innovation that OOH has done is significant, but nobody showcasing it. I think, so I just coming back to the same point, somebody has to kind of just be the flag bearer on that.
Just to add on that outdoor and digital point, I think we can learn a lot from the developed markets like UK and all that. They have done a lot of studies. In fact, Binet and Field, they had done study, and it's little shocking for me, which says that if you combine outdoor and digital, the effectiveness on the business results actually goes up by 37% compared to if you do only outdoor, which is only 17%. So if you do this hand-in-hand kind of campaigns with outdoor and digital, there is a miracle happening, right? They have actually calibrated that. But unfortunately, which is the second part I'm coming to, when you said ki, lot of people come together from digital industry, and like she said, they are educating us and all that. Beyond that, I think the most important factor about digital also is that there is no third-party measurement for digital also, but still it's growing. Why? Because at the same, when it doesn't have a third-party measurement, me at my end actually can put trackers in my campaign and measure the data, which is not available. right? For example, when we did IPL activities, the most expensive activity, I wanted to know what is the number. So we, at the end of the campaign, in fact, every day I used to get the number from Hotstar, what is that number? And that's not Hotstar reliant number. It's the number which I used to measure from my end. So this kind of metric is not available at outdoor, and that's the challenge I think industry is facing. While kind of campaigns we do, we look at outdoor only as the broadcasting medium. Why can't it be a TV kind of a medium? Why can't it be like 4 week or I never use a outdoor for sustenance campaign. Why can't I use outdoor for sustenance? Why can't I use outdoor for frequency campaigns? It has that capacity caliber, but I don't, maybe let me put it this way. Do I have trust to do that? Do I have confidence to do that? Maybe the answer is no, because I don't have anything coming back from outdoor industry. This is what we can deliver.
Exactly. So we are coming back to the same thing that, you know, there is a syndicated research which will give you a kind of confidence that yes, it is delivering the number.
Either syndicated results or like, you know, there are a lot of, if you see, like I mentioned, developed markets, they are doing those analytical studies. Outdoor industry is coming together and they are showing how outdoor is effective. Sure. Can we do such kind of studies in India specific to Indian markets, specific to certain categories who are spenders on outdoor, and show us some faith on outdoor?
Just one point I want to add what he said is that, you know, and I'm sharing a recent example which we did at Z. One of our channel went anchorless, okay, and we launched a campaign for it. Now, we used all mediums, especially outdoor, and we hold it digital for some time, okay. Now, with the use of outdoor and other mediums, you know, actually the campaign went viral, and we saved the entire budget for the digital and plow back into the outdoor. Yeah, so, you know, there are multiple cases in point, which I'm sure everybody's mentioned about it here, is that there are cases which needs to be presented and a marketer needs to be educated about how outdoor can actually be so effective in certain cases where you end up saving a lot of money, you know, which you plan for digital because it goes viral.
Great. I'll quickly move on. This is the last question due to paucity of time. I'll just quickly ask, starting from you, Sujit, what is that one thing would you look forward from OOH which will help in gain more share in the overall advertising pie?
Yeah, so this is something which is the point of discussion when we discuss every campaign launch. And there are two important things which as a marketer we look forward from outdoor. Is that, you know, for us, it's a campaign which has to be successful. For media owners, it becomes that media which they want to push into the campaign. What we look at is the entire integrated approach of marketing, at how this whole integration, you know, is going to give benefit to me. So if outdoor is presenting something, how it can leverage digital as a medium, how it can leverage other things as a medium to drive engagement and not really be, you know, on their own, which is what, you know, the commoditization of outdoor is the point number one.
Sure. Sai, you? One thing which will help outdoor to gain advertising pie?
There is just one thing that's defined the ROI.
Great.
Very simple. There is no excuses.
How about you, Pramod?
I will not say how the one thing to increase advertising share, but that one thing I would definitely demand and expect. I mean, I understand a lot of expectations, but so as we are here, we should move forward in the eco-friendly zone, I think. There's this need of our to think about how we can do away with from flakes and go towards digital outdoor. That's I think, the point where we should think about that. In UK, I think in 5 years, there is a 45% market share, which is like half market share, which is made by digital outdoor holdings. So if that market is doing so much, why can't we move towards that? I think rather than share, I would be really seriously looking forward for environment-friendly kind of outdoor holdings. Flex is damn, it's bad
sure.
for environment.
Okay, great. So over and above the measurement piece which Sai has said, I think how does the industry retain talent in this medium? How do you keep improving the kind of quality of talent that comes into the industry. I think that's very critical.
Great.
I know we are running out of time, but I'll just mention four instead of one. So one, of course, everybody's spoken about it again and again, independent measurement metrics. Just one sentence to add, it impacts budget allocations. Because in a professional environment, all budget allocations are based on database and not gut-based.
Absolutely.
Right? Number two, professionalization at ground level is happening. Things are changing rapidly, but still it's a big country and many locations, you still have loosely organized entities on the ground. Mm-hmm. So now that has to change.
Okay.
Number three would be cost rationalization. That impacts resource allocation once again. And number four would be greater engagement between the outdoor media industry and the brand owners and the marketing professionals. That would make a world of difference.
Great, thank you. Lastly, Jayesh.
Everybody said whatever I wanted to say. Anyways, sir, 2 points from mine. One is probably a brand solution team equivalent the way television channels have.
Mm-hmm.
And second would be investment in training and people.
Oh, okay. Great. So thank you so much, everyone. I think it has been a lovely, engaging session. We got to know quite a few things. And overall, I could say that, you know, we would say that how Sam started in that Pitch Madison report, that happy days are here again this year. So I would say the same thing applies to OOH now, that we would see, you know, more and more efforts are being taken by the Outdoor Advertising Association. And we hear now from the marketeers that unless and until that is the need of an hour, and that is the thing which is going to help us get more pie in the advertising share. So thank you very much. Thank you, panel. Thank you, everyone, for